To put it simply, expensive bikes are just fucking stupid. I mean, really think of it. You're spending thousands of dollars on a pedal bike. On a pedal bike. Thousands of dollars on a pedal bike. Firstly, I can buy a Yamaha R6, which is a pretty nice beginner motorcycle, for about 13,000 brand new. But some people decide to spend it on a pedal bike that can barely go 20 miles an hour. To say the least, it's pretty stupid. Or is it? Cycling is a sport many outsiders would barely understand. $1,000 on a bike seems like a very obscure idea to many. Most people never even spend a couple hundred dollars on a bike their whole life. Most are thinking, why not spend this money on a car or a motorcycle? Why are you spending it on a pedal bike? This is stupid. I mean, bicycles are simple machines. They have thousands upon thousands, or probably in tens of thousands, less parts than a car, and they're a kid's toy, to put it quite simply. But really, this idea can be transferred over into any sport. You're guaranteed to spend stupid amounts of money, whether that be a couple hundred or a couple $1,000, on things such as a swimsuit or running shoes. Let's take swimming for example. A premium swimsuit is about $500. The way I see it is, why don't you just spend $30 on a pair of swim trunks? They work the same, right? And everyone who's listening who's a swimmer is going to say, that's where you're wrong. You see, you're not spending these hundreds or thousands of dollars on a swimsuit. You're spending it on the technology behind a swimsuit to make you marginally faster and more competitive in the sport. You're paying for the millions of dollars of research and development that went into making these swimsuits. You're buying the performance to do better. It's like getting running shoes. The more you spend on running shoes, the more efficient power transfer you will see when using those running shoes. That's why if you spend a couple hundred dollars on running shoes, you'll see a difference relative to $20 running shoes. And this exact same idea can be applied to pedal bikes. One cool thing we have in the world of cycling is called the Union Cycliste Internationale. It's also known as the UCI. This is basically like the governing body of everything bike related. So if you want a bike to be used in an event, it has to be approved by the UCI. And one cool rule the UCI has is that once they approve your bike, one of the matters of approval is you have to be able to sell it to anyone and everyone who wants it. This means those UCI approved track bikes that they use in the Olympics, the ones that are $80,000, have to be able to be bought by the average Joe.
Check out my video on the $80,000 track bike that failed.
And this is a majority as to where these insane bike prices come from. In very few sports, the average Joe is rarely able to purchase breaking edge technology that is going to be used that concurrent year inside of the Pro League. This means you could buy the bike that the Tour de France winner used. You could buy a crazy bike that the Tour de France, the top of the top, winner used. For those of you who don't understand what I'm saying, this is basically like being able to buy Max Verstappen's F1 car. If you had the money, get off YouTube and get your money up. And then being able to use that car for personal use, which is insane because F1, they hide everything and the regulations are really odd, but they can still be hidden. And this law that everyone has to be able to buy anything you produce within the UCI annoys bike manufacturers a lot. The reason as to why these Olympic track bikes cost a lot of money is because these companies do not want to make these bikes for you. So if you do order it, they want to make a shit ton of money off of the little time they spend on making the bike, because they do not see a point in making them. These bikes that are supposedly $80,000 for you to purchase were made for a specific reason, and these manufacturers only wanted to use that for that specific reason. They wanted to set a monumental goal with it, not mass produce it. Because mass producing it would be a pain in the ass, and they don't really want to dabble in the technology it will take to do it. The same fact of the matter can be seen relative in running. If you guys know who Eliud Kipchoge is, he's the guy who broke the sub 2-hour marathon, and Nike made a special shoe for him. The shoe that he used to break this 2-hour marathon was called the Nike Air Zoom Alphafly Next Percent, and this shoe had 3 carbon plates in it and some insane amount of technology in it, but they really only made this shoe for him and a bunch of other runners who were helping him break this 2-hour marathon. Of course, some exceptions like some top runners or some crazy influencers got these shoes, but the average Joe was never really able to purchase them. Later on, they did come out with a much more running legal shoe and easier to produce. However, due to the demand of the shoe, they later released a dumbed down version of it for peasant use. But again, that's the cool thing about biking. Anything you produce that is used within an event and is UCI approved has to be able to be bought by the average consumer. Now let's talk relative to the producers who don't fall into that don't want you to buy their bike category. Most of it comes down for high-end parts and technology, and some of you might be blown away by this, but there is such thing as electric and wireless shifting on a bike. They don't need cables. It's fully Bluetooth and electric. It's really, really cool. As you may know, technology costs a lot of money, and some of these systems, such as SRAM with their Access system or Shimano with their DI2 system, they cost thousands of dollars for a group set. And this electric shifting system probably cost millions of dollars in development and millions more to make. So that $3,000 price tag for a whole group set is somewhat justified. Now, if you ever get to ride one of these, oh my gosh, they are beautiful. I just love wireless shifting. It's always accurate and it's really nice to ride on. Definitely try it if you get the chance. And there's many more instances of technology such as wireless shifting being produced and sold throughout the whole bike industry. So this really begs the question, would you spend over $10,000 on a bike or even a few thousand dollars on a bike? Or do the benefits of what you get not justify the price tag? And if you did buy an expensive ass bike, what do you think of it? Make sure to like and subscribe. I post YouTube shorts daily, and let me know down below. But nonetheless, have a great rest of your day.